الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت، ذي العزة والجبروت. الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام، عزيز لا يضام، قهار لا يرام. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. O you who believe, fear Allah as He should be feared, and dare not except on a state of Islam. May Allah the Most Merciful grant us this great gift to die on a state of Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us rich Ramadan. Allahumma balighna Ramadan. Ya Arhamar Rahimin. Ya Rabbal Alameen. Amma ba'd. The guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the guidance that will take you to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in His Quran, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Say, if you truly love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah will forgive you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will love you back, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you with sins, because Allah is the oft forgiven, the most merciful, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is in every aspect of his life. And the way how he used to teach us, even how to deal with everything around us. And one of the most important fact, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he used doing things, he always take them from the teaching, from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him, the way how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make him to have this morality, and a morality that above the greatest of the moral, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to his prophet, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. You are on the greatest moral, above the greatest of the moral. The guidance of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to teach us things, how we articulate our deep of our belief with the action of our life. One of the things that the Prophet ﷺ is teaching us to be a part of our behavior, part of our conduct, which will give you the stronger willingness, which will give you tranquility in acting, which is giving you strength in initiating the question, the actions. One of these great guidance, as the Prophet ﷺ called it, al-fa'lu al-hasan, al-fa'lu al-hasan. As in حديث الصحيحين مروي عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله تعالى عنه قال يعجبني الفأل الكلمة الحسنة. I love the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the good omen. I love optimism. I love to think things, to look at things from a positive way. And this فأل is the good word, الكلمة الحسنة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when someone came to him and accepted Islam, and his name kind of not going with this architecture, if you can say, of the good omen, architecture of positivism. Because one of the characteristics of the Islamic aqidah is positivism, to be positive. And we'll explain that, inshallah ta'ala. So one came, a companion, radiallahu ta'ala, he accepted Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told him, what's his name? قال حزن, حزن, something like sad. And حزن, also something like harsh. Hard. قال بل أنت سهل. بل أنت سهل. You are an easy. So his name, Allah the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم give him a new name, not to be harsh and not to be sad, but someone he is easy. A lady from the companion رضي الله تعالى عنها, she came, her name was عاصية. عاصية. And this is the type in that society they used to protect themselves from the evil omen, so they give bad names. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told her, you're not عاصية, you are جميلة. You're not Asiya, you're not a sinner. You're not Asiya, someone who's difficult, someone who's always opposing the current thing of good. You are Jamila, you are beautiful. And her name became Jamila. Therefore, the Prophet ﷺ is teaching us this guidance, as Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu in Musnad al-Imam Ahmad, he said, قال كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتفاءل ولا يتطير ويحب الاسم الحسن. ويحب الاسم الحسن. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to make this good omen, to be optimist, to always talk about good. And he doesn't like the evil omen. He actually prohibited the evil omen. ويحب الاسم الحسن, and he loves the good names. As in Sulh al-Hudaybiyah, after the argument that they have and this kind of the settlement between them, between the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and Quraysh, finding to get to a truth, every time they sent someone, it didn't work out. When they sent Suhail ibn Amr, look, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he thought in his name that he's going to be the solution with this man, that we're going to have an agreement with his name. When he told him, قال هذا سهيل سهل الله أمركم. This is Suhail. Suhail is coming from the root of the word sahal, and sahal is easy. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, this name, his name is Suhail. May Allah make your settlement with them, your agreement with them to be sahal, to be easy. So this is the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in looking at things in a positive way. It is embedded in our aqidah. Because when you face a difficulty, the first thing, the shaitan, he will come to you and threat you with poverty, threat you with difficult things, threat you with defeat, threat you with everything except to give you some positive omen or some positive thinking or to give you hope. And that is contradicting with the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he's contradicting with the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because when someone he is facing a difficulty, the first thing, when he's scared, when he thinks that it is the end, there's no hope. And if there is no hope, there is no power to initiate any action. There is no power to fulfill any achievement or to do any objective. Why? Because that feeling of sadness, that feeling of fear, it really break all your moral, so you cannot do anything. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in his book, he explained to us things that we need to revisit and to look. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran when you read, and this is how we're not going to have optimism and not have good omen based on things like, you know, illusion, based on things that, you know, fake belief. No, our good omen, our optimism is based on a structure, is based on a foundation which is settled in our belief. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُعْجِزَهُ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي السَّمَاءِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing was to make him incapable. Nothing will escape from Allah, whatever in the heaven and the earth. And Allah كَانَ عَلِيمًا قَدِيرًا. He had the all knowledge and he had the all power. And this is your God. Think of that. When you have a problem, Nothing in the heaven or the earth will stop Allah. Nothing can overcome Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever you have around you, anyone who has kingdom, anyone who has power, anyone who has anything, anyone who has things like arrogance because of his money, and someone who wants to persecute you, and they want you to make you kneel down to scare you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you the Quran, قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء وتعز من تشاء وتذل من تشاء بيدك الخير إنك على كل شيء قدير. That's how you settle the iman in your heart. Say, oh Allah, the king of the kings, you provide kingdom to whom you will, and you take it away, you arrest it from whom you will. وتعز من تشاء, and you glorify, you honor whom you want, and you humiliate whom you want, ya Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In your hand is goodness. In your hand is all the khair. إِنَّكَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. You have power over all things. That is the iman. When you come to the destiny, you say, I'm controlled, this is predestined. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell you in Surah Al-Ra'd, يَمْحُ اللَّهُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيُثْبِتْ وَعِنْدَهُ أُمُّ الْكِتَابِ. Allah erase whatever he will. Therefore, when you are encountering things, you not say, this is the destiny, I cannot do anything. No, Allah has the power to erase something that you thought is in a destiny, because the destiny, only Allah knows that who is being written in the Lawh al-Mahfuz. But your action, at every action you do, your destiny is changing. You actually, the architect, you are the designer of your own destiny. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال, يَمْحُ اللَّهُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيُثْبِتُ وَعِنْدَهُ أُمُّ الْكِتَابِ. Therefore, when you're encountering things, you say, this is the end. It's not the end. You are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has the power over all things, and He has the destiny to rewrite it, because He knows everything, and He knows what is going to happen to you, and He knows that if you hold fast to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will make easy in your situation, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَن يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. That is the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whoever who fear Allah, whoever who show piety to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah make for him a way out, and He will provide him from way that he could not even expect. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us in the Quran, إِيَّمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِذُرٍ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّهُ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala touch you with difficulty, no one can remove it. No one had the relief in his hand except Allah. Therefore, whatever difficulty you have, no one has the power to inflict it on you. It comes from Allah. Turn to Allah. وَإِيَّمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِخَيْرٍ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would touch you with good, He is the one who had the power over all things. And the other ayah, قَالَ فَلَا رَدَّ لِفَضْلِهِ. No one will stop it. No one. يَفْتَحِ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى mercy on people, no one can stop it. And no one can hold anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inflict of other. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who had the power, the one who had the irada. Our God, He's not passive. Our God is not out of our creation, like in different faiths. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's with you. وَهُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ. And He's with you wherever you are. He's with you if you are locked in a cave, He's with you. He was with Yunus in the stomach of the whale. He was in the Ibrahim while being thrown in the fire. He was with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in all the situations that you know at difficult time. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is knowing Allah will obligate on us to be optimist, to have the good omen. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam قال أبشروا وأملوا ما يسركم. أملوا, أبشروا, have the glad tidings. In every action you do, have the glad tidings. Because your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever happened to you in the dunya, is part of the destiny, is part of the trial. It might be something painful, but you are with Allah, He's going to make it easy for you. You are with Allah, He's going to reward it for you. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أبشروا وأملوا ما يسركم. And always hope what makes you happy. Always hope what makes you joyful. So this is aqidah, this is a belief. To be optimist, to have the good omen is a belief in the Islamic creed. It's the guidance of the Prophet ﷺ. It's the way of the Prophet ﷺ. More than that, the Prophet ﷺ, he loves to do everything with his right hand. قَالَ كَانَ يَتَرَجَّلُ بِيَدْهِ بِالْيُمْنَ أَنْ يَتَنَعَّلُ بِالْيُمْنَ. Everything. So the scholar analyzing to relate it, to associate it with the foundation of the belief, he said, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قَالَ أَصْحَابُ الْيَمِينَ, the people of the right hand. Therefore, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by good omen, he always used everything with the right hand to connect it with the foundation of the aqidah, to connect it of what you are wishing, what you are hoping to have. And this is subhanAllah in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you look at the Quran, the positivism in the Islamic aqidah is not only a belief, is a characteristic. When we say characteristic, is a sima, is an attribute, is a qualification. When we talk about belief, you only think of positive. When you talk about belief, arhamur rahimin. When you talk about belief, you talk about relief. When you talk about belief, you talk about happiness. When you talk about belief, you talk about joy. And that's in the positivism. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us in the Quran, in all the aspects of the Quran, you will see this positivism, and you see this optimism, and you see always this good omen. Ummu Ismail عليه السلام, when Ibrahim عليه السلام left her in the desert with her baby Ismail, and he didn't even want to look to her. He could not. So he left her with a little bit of water and some food. She told him in the end, Allah told you to do this. And he didn't answer. She knew that Allah, look the optimism, look the good omen, look the good thinking of Allah. قال فإنه لا يضيعون أبدا. He will not neglect us, Allah. And you know the rest of the story. Ibrahim عليه السلام, when he was by the fire, just to reflect, you know all this story, but look it from this perspective. He wasn't scared. He wasn't saying like, this is the end, this is my death. He wasn't complaining. He has full serenity in his heart. Even he declined the help of Jibreel alayhi salam. He declined. قال أما منك فلا حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. Allah is my sufficient. And he is the best, the disposer of my affairs, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when he was flying, if we can, flying in the air to get to the fire, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered. That's the result of the positivism. That's the result of your trust. That's your result, the next step. You don't know it. It's not created. It's going to be positive. Why? Because in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah ordered us to have a good thinking of him. قال أنا عند حسن ظني عبدي بي. I deal with my servant the way he thinks of me. If you think positive of Allah, if you think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to help you, Allah will help you. But if you think negative of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that type of thinking will lead for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let you with yourself. He will not help you. Why? Because you have a deficiency in the way how you think of your own creator subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know the story with Abi Bakr. And them, Abu Jahl and the soldier, if they just look at their feet, at their side, at their toes, they will see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Abu Bakr was really concerned about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's going to be the end of Islam if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is killed. قال ما بالك باثنين. What do you think of two? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ثالثهم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the third. And amazingly, we'll go back to the story of Yaqub alayhi salam. He lost his first son. And after years, they say the scholar, maybe more than 30 years, he lost the second son. When they came back to him, what did he say? What did he say? That's subhanAllah positivism. That you think in good of Allah. You'll be optimist. You hope the good, so say it out loud. No one can stop it. Allah make it happen. قَالَ عَصَى اللَّهُ أَن يَأْتِيَنِي بِهِمْ جَمِيعًا. Allah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring them all. They're talking about Benjamin, the second son, and him, he's talking about Yusuf that he lost 30 years ago. And then when he told him, قَالَ فَاذْهَبُوا وَتَحَسَّسُوا مِنْ يُوسُفَ وَأَخِيهِ. Go and check about brother, Yusuf and his brother. We're talking about Yusuf alayhi salam. Yeah, Yaqub, when you missed him, when you lost him, you didn't see him for 30 years. So that way that makes them to wonder, to question, what did he say? قال ولا تيأسوا من روح الله. Do not despair in the soothing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the hope of Allah. Never give up. Because only give up that, the hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who do not have belief. And this is our aqidah. You don't have money today. Allah will provide it to you tomorrow. But have the serenity, that power in your heart that he will. If you have difficulty that you're encountering today, just say, Ya Allah. But just think from the depth of your heart that Allah is going to give you the solution. It is in your heart. It's not what is going to happen tomorrow. Tomorrow is not created yet. I'll keep reminding myself and you, tomorrow is not created yet. Is your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn that creation to be in your favor. يمحو الله ما يشاء ويثبت. And this is subhanAllah to say. Many people when they read the Quran, they said, this is Hajar alayhi salam. This is Ibrahim, the friend of Allah. What about us? Who are we for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to look at us? He said, you're wrong. You're wrong. Because you are a servant of Allah. As long as he gave you the gift to make sujood, just have that power in your heart to trust him, you will see what Allah will do for you. And I'll give you two examples from the Quran. A family that is poor from Medina. And they have kind of problem, household problem. The man, Aws ibn Samit, he got mad with his wife. قال أنتي علي كظهر أمي. You are like my mother back. It becomes haram on him. And this is what they have in Jahiliyyah. It's like a separation. So to him, how come? At this age, and I have kids, if I'm going to leave them to you, they're going to be like, you know, just, you know, lost. If I'm going to keep them, I don't have money. She went to the Prophet ﷺ. She went to the Prophet ﷺ complaining. He said, look what he did for me. After this day, age, after I served, after I did, look what he did. The Prophet ﷺ doesn't have an answer. And this is, ikhwani, the positivism. This is the aqidah. This is the beauty. This is how Allah is close to you. Is a poor family, a lady. She's not a prophet. She's not in the level of Abu Bakr. She's not in the level of Umar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala heard her and sent down of Quran to defend her. قَدْ سَمِعَ اللَّهُ قَوْلَ الَّتِي تُجَادِلُكَ فِي زَوْجِهَا وَتَشْتَكِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. When you make shakwa to Allah, Allah is listening to you. A lady from the Ansar. Therefore, don't say who I am. Yes, you are. You are a servant of Allah. You are a servant of Allah, dignified and honored by the belief and by the sujood and by the salah and by the dua. Therefore, do not despair. And use this fa'al al-hasan as a guidance, as a conduct. Do not have any way of pessimism. Wallahi, if you don't have anything today, just trust in Allah. Not trust, just talk it, say it. Say it. Allah will never let me down. Why? Because you have that fa'al hasan. You have that good omen. You have that optimism. Because Allah had the power to do it. Not out of nothing. Out of foundation of our creed. Out of our knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Blind. You know his story. Abdullah ibn Ummi Maktoum. He came asking for guidance, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was busy. He didn't pay attention to him. And when he held him, and he was blind, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has a frowny face. It was something that he could not control. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reproached his Prophet in the Quran because of this man. عبس وتولى أن جاءه الأعمى. To know, oh you believer, all of you, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala care about you, that Allah listen to you. It's about us who don't have good thinking of Allah. It's about us that we do not truly the greatness of Allah. It's about us that we belittle ourselves and we think that Allah will not listen to us. I'm then giving you, Allah give us example in the Quran. And this good omen and this optimism help the believer to have the strength in his heart. Have the believer to have that compassion, to have this love, to have the kindness. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he wants always good. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him Jibreel with the angel of the mountains, and he told him, Ya Rasulullah, this is the angel of the mountain. He came to you to give him your order, and he's able, by the permission of Allah, to crush the whole people of At-Ta'if, and in another riwayah, the people of Mecca. What did he say? Because he had this positivism, he's always thinking good. What is the best of these people? To accept the belief and Allah be pleased with them, or for Allah to torture them and to punish them? Qala no, la. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala get from out of their offspring people who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they do not associate any partner with him. And he give you strength. As a last story, to help us thinking positive of Allah and having this optimism in your heart that give you security. When Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an has a problem with Quraysh, and he had the jira, the protection of Ibn al-Daghina. This is how they had before. They have a protection, so they leave him alone because he accepted Islam. Abu Bakr, he was a great worshipper. He stand reciting in his house, but it was a courtyard, and he reciting the Quran. The whole people of the neighborhood, from women and kids, they come around the wall listening to Abu Bakr. The people they want of Quraysh, they say, this one, he's making a problem for us. Ibn al-Daghina, you have to take care of the one that you protect her. So Ibn al-Daghina came to him, he told him, yeah, Abu Bakr. I mean, I don't want that the people of Quraysh, they said they're going to, you know, to neglect you or to have like, you know, negate my promise to you. But please do not read Quran anymore. You are making fitna for me. He told them, Ibn al-Daghina, I throw your protection. I have jiratullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because he knows that Allah is going to protect him. Because he had the trust. Because he has al-fa'l al-hasan. And this is may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to settle in our heart. To look things in all your life that is positive. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Abshiru wa ammilu ma yasurrakum. Abshiru, have the glad tidings. As he said it in the night of Ghazwat Badr. Before one night, they were the third of the army. He told them, Abshiru, have the glad tidings. And it happened in Ramadan. Inshallah, we'll celebrate it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us, to give us and make us and give us the gift to reach Ramadan. Give them, he told them, Abshiru, wasiru wa abshiru. Get the glad tidings even before they start the battle. Why? Because it's settled in the heart. You think good of Allah. Allah will treat you the way you think of him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي, أقول قولي قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. Being the guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, founded in the belief. And when we say in the belief in the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it becomes an obligation for us. It becomes an obligation for us to only think good, to only say good, to only to be optimist. And the people here, they said, half of the glass full or empty, for a believer must be always full. Wallahi, even if you don't have anything in your pocket, you are rich. Wallahi, you are rich. Just believe it and you will see it. You will see the smile on your heart and in you the glowing of the light in your face if you just trust and you just know how great Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala it's you. Have this positivism anchored in your heart. But one thing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you. In the hadith that I mentioned, قَالَ أَبْشِرُوا وَأَمِّلُوا مَا يَسُرَّكُمْ. Have the glad tidings and always hope. What make you happy? The continuation of the hadith, I left it in the end. قَالَ فَإِنِّي لَا أَخْشَى عَلَيْكُمُ الْفَقْرِ. My concern, I don't fear poverty on you. Poverty will not destroy you. Poverty will not take joy out of you. Why? Because the rizq, the provision in the hand of Allah al-Qadir, al-Razaq. قَالَ وَلَكِنْ أَخَافُ أَن تُبْسَطَ عَلَيْكُمُ الدُّنْيَا. My fear is that the dunya, the worldly life, will open up for you, will give you a lot of abundance, a lot of provision. Then you're going to race and compete in the dunya, and it's going to destroy you as it did for the people before you. And this is the last wasiyah from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's not about poverty, actually. It's about the money that you might have, about the profit, about the rizq that you have. Manage it in the way of Allah. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you barakah and to protect you. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يبارك لنا في أرزاقنا. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا ووفقنا لاجتنابه. اللهم بلغنا رمضان. اللهم ثبت قلوبنا على الإيمان. اللهم يا مصرف القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم اغفر لنا يا كريم يا أرحم الراحمين يا أكرم الأكرمين يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة يرحمكم الله.